can show me how to love. Maybe I'm going through a drought. You don't even have to do too much. You can turn me on with just a touch. Baby,
good morning, Memphis. Good morning, Lucky. Good morning, Hope.
Good morning.
Top of the morning, 66, getting up to 82, mostly sunny skies in Memphis, 901.
And this weekend, it's going to be awesome. We're going to set your Memorial Weekend right, get you started for summer with a bunch of throwbacks. Whatever kind of music you want to hear, we're going to play for you at 375-1075. But right now, we want to know, what's that one piece of technology that you could get rid of?
Hey, Nick's got one talking to us on the Q1075 stream. He says computers.
Computers?
Just the ones at work, though.
We're in the home stretch of the hard times. We took a hard left. But we're all right. Yeah, life sure can try to put love to it, but we built this right. So nothing's ever gonna move it. When the bones are good, the rest don't matter. Yeah, the pain could peel, the glass could shatter. Let it rain, 'cause you and I remain the same. When the the way
the bones are good, the rest don't matter. Yeah, the pain could peel, the glass could shatter. Let it break.
The number one hit music station, Q107.5, Laddie, Lucky, and Hope in the morning.
Hey, good morning, Laddie. 66, mostly sunny in Memphis, getting up to 82. It's 9:04.
Coming up at 9:30, it's going to be your Netflix check. We want to know what you're watching out there. I just watched a new movie yesterday.
Ooh.
Well, it's not new. It's pretty old, but still. Yay!
I saw a classic movie the other day. It was good.
375-1075. We want to know, what piece of technology would you get rid of?
I've got the best one, guys.
What you got?
Okay.
I think this piece of technology is so silly. Like, you must be really lazy if you have this.
Knee pads?
No.
Scooters?
No.
Okay.
Alexa.
Alexa?
Whoa.
You know, like the Alexa that you have in your house is a speaker, whatever, and you can just be like, Alexa, do this for me.
Alexa, yeah. Play Q107.5 in the radio and it turns on. Yeah, why would you want to get rid of that?
Because, like, what's the point? You can't pick up your phone and, like, change a station or turn on music yourself.
Not if you're holding a coffee and a sandwich in your other hand. It's nice to just be able to say it.
I don't know. It's a little lazy to me, guys.
A little lazy.
Gotta admit it. I will never own an Alexa.
No, I don't know about that. Alexa, you know what she can do also? I think she can mess with your thermostat. Alexa, yeah. Make it 23 degrees up in here.
Like, come on, just walk.
Hey, Hope, for your birthday, we got you an Alexa.
Yeah.
We really hope you enjoy it.
I'll donate it.
No, actually, we got her the bootleg named Malexa. But right now, 375-1075, what about you? What kind of piece of technology would you get rid of?
Turn the lights down low, hide it. I'm here to
The number one hit music station, Q107.5, Lattie Lucky and Hope in the Morning.
It's 70 in the great city of Memphis, mostly sunny, getting up to 82, 909.
Coming up this weekend for Memorial Day weekend, we're getting you in the mood of summer, and we're playing all your favorite throwbacks. You can actually request songs at 375-1075. Yeah, but right now, there's technology, pieces of technology all over the world, and we use them every day, but some of them we just want to get rid of. What are the pieces of technology you want to get rid of at 375-1075?
That's tough. That's tough because, you know, we're making advancements in this world, and to really go backwards?
But some are kind of like making us lazy and, you know, like damaging us in a way.
Well, there are certain inventions and products. I think we all agree that we need to get rid of them.
Right.
A prime example of that is the shampoo conditioner combo.
you don't like that?
That we see so often. If you talk to any hairstylist, now I despise it. You talk to any hairstylist out there, they say you don't mix the two together and put it in your hair.
That's so bad for your hair.
It's bad for it, right? Hope knows. And here's the thing. I mean, like, you got an extra minute, 30 seconds to apply some conditioner after the shampoo. You can do it. You can find time, get up an extra minute and a half early to do that, to give your hair the nutrients it deserves.
Yeah, let it sit while you're, you know, putting your body wash on or something, shaving your beard, whatever.
You can do that.
But, you know, now they also have the 3-in-1. It's the shampoo, conditioner, and hashtag body wash to where you can do all of it in the shower.
Can I change mine?
You can change it now. But it's so crazy that they have that, right?
Yeah, it sounds really bad for you.
That's ridiculous. Yeah. Now, look, if you only got 3 seconds to sleep, I get it.
Right.
Use it. Use that stuff. You know what I'm talking about? But time management is very important.
It's very, very important. You know, there's a lot of technology out there that I think that we could just get rid of. And one of the things that I'm not a fan of, I hate the cameras at the intersections that take a picture of you. So you're having a wonderful day and you're like, I'm going to go check the mail. I'm getting my stimulus check. And It's a bill or it's a ticket saying, hey, you ran a red light. Here's a picture of your car tags. This is you. You did this. Now you owe us $5,000. I'm like, wait, what? No, I don't do that.
You weren't there.
Maybe you should stop running red lights, Lottie.
No, hold on. No. See, what happened was, I didn't
went
through
fault.
To
the... What happened?
It wasn't your fault.
It wasn't my fault, but I hate that. I mean, yeah. Literally, that's happened to me twice. I've gone out to get the mail and thinking I'm having a great day. Like, I'll even take, like, cheap coupons, and then it says, hey, you ran this red light, here's a picture of your tags, you're gonna owe us money, you can mail this in, you're going to court, or you're gonna be in jail forever. Like,
so I've never gotten one of those, so I think you're just a really bad driver. Maybe you need to just work on that.
No, they are bad. I mean, like, I'm serious. They get everybody if you run through that thing.
I'm telling you, everyone. And like, I look for them too now. You know? And then what's crazy is that even if you stop at a red light, then you'll see like a second in the corner of your eye, you'll see like a flash.
Yeah.
Boom. That's the thing.
Yeah. That's it.
So,
it's a bad feeling right there when you see that flash.
It's a horrible feeling. And it's an even worse feeling getting the ticket that you're going to have to pay for.
Yes.
I mean, I'm not saying that someone should go up there and put gum on the lens of the camera. I'm not saying I'm going to do it. But I mean, if there's an intersection that I go through, you might as well do that for your boy.
I mean, sometimes you got to change out the street lights, you know, or you got to change out the traffic lights. Come on, my man.
Well, good thing we have lawyer Bill to like help us out through those situations now.
Absolutely right. Hey, Bill, get a ladder and some gum, brother. You're the man.
Q107.5 is taking your playlist. Slide into our DM.
At Q107.5.
Hey, it's Dua Lipa.
This is Adam Levine of Maroon 5.
I'm not horny.
The number one hit music station.
You've been running around, throwing that dirt all on my name. Cause you knew that I'd call you up. You've been going around every party in LA. Cause you knew that I'd be at one. Oh. I know that dress is karma, perfume regret. You got me thinking about when you were mine. Oh. And now I'm all upon you, what you expect. But you're not coming home with me tonight. You just want attention. You don't want my heart. Maybe you just hate the thought of me with someone new. Yeah, you just want attention. I knew from the start. You're just making sure.
is karma, perfume regret. You got me thinking about when you were mine. And now I'm all up on you, what you expect? But you're not coming home with me tonight. You just want attention.
The number one hit music station, Q107.5, Laddie, Lucky, and Hope in the Morning.
Might be the greatest day we've seen in a very, very long time. It's 70, mostly sunny, getting up to 82 in Memphis, 916.
Tomorrow around 7 o'clock at night, prom from home with our very own Zach Sang and St. Jude. Basically, it's under the lights in your living room. He's going to have a bunch of cool different artists like AJR, Bozzy, Asher Angel. And they're going to be performing for you at your own prom, basically, right?
That's going to be fun.
Yeah, grab a few friends, get dressed up in your prom dress. I know you ladies already bought one. Might as well use it.
I got to give a shout out to my boy Jake. He just sent me a video, and you should send us videos as well as you dancing. My buddy Jake just sent me one. He's doing the Carlton dance. Remember that
yes.
from Fresh Prince? He just sent that one. And then I have one that I made on TikTok, so I'm going to put that in. You can put make a small little video. Just be like maybe 8, 6, 7, 10 seconds long, you know?
That's not long.
Yeah, put it on our Facebook page at Q107.5. We'll just take it from there, and we'll make it happen.
You have enough dance moves for 10 seconds. You can do that. You can
absolutely.
Do yeah, I got some moves too.
Right now at 375-1075. What piece of technology would you get rid of? And I mean, is it the electric slide? You know, I mean, you know, dance is a piece of technology. But what would you get rid of at 375-1075?
We got a text coming through on the text line, 235-1075. Olaf is talking to us, and Olaf would get rid of the panini maker. The panini maker. It's like a, I don't know.
That's useless.
The panini maker?
Well, I think it heats it. I think, like, you already make the panini, I guess, and then you press it in the panini press. I guess,
but
I guess
who
more like,
makes paninis, you know?
Well, it's like it's a sandwich.
Yeah, but, well, like, you get one at a restaurant, maybe, but you're not going to go, like, I'm not going to make one at home.
What? You mean you don't got a panini guy?
I don't.
I got a panini guy. Everyone's got a panini guy.
Yeah. I don't know about everyone.
But, you know, they upset Olaf greatly, so he wants to get rid of him. He didn't like him.
I tell you, there's a lot of different inventions out there and pieces of technology, man. You just got to get rid of, you know, like I said, like I'm not about the camera.
Yeah,
it's
going to
take a picture of me
camera
when I'm
on the
driving.
Light at the intersection.
Yeah, I don't like that one at all. You know, and I know there's other ones, too, out there. Like, the what's the thing? The caller ID. You don't need that anymore. You can get rid of it.
Yeah.
You know?
The caller ID.
Right. That people have at their home phones. Nobody has a home phone anymore.
Yeah.
So you don't need the little caller ID thing that shows you have a cell phone.
I think they did get rid of that, though, right? I mean, we don't. Do they still sell those?
Dude, they better.
They still got them.
A rotary phone.
You know what you might consider getting rid of, Hope, and I apologize, but that weird apparatus that curls your eyelashes. That strange
the eyelash
thing.
Curler.
That thing looks dangerous. Yeah, get rid of that thing.
Yeah, I can poke an eye out.
Ooh, yeah, I know. It's not good at all.
I don't use it. I don't need it.
Yeah, like in some hair products like that, dude, that can hurt you as well, you know?
Like a curling iron or something.
I have been burnt by a curling iron more than one time.
So one time I had a straightener and I was straightening my hair and it fell in between my foot and burned like the bottom of my foot and the top of my foot. So yeah. I try and stay away from those two.
We got to get rid of that technology. That's a great technology to get rid of. It's very dangerous.
More harmful than good.
That's right, curly haired people. Not anymore. You're never going straight again. Ah.
Q107.5, the number one hit music station, asking everyone to wash your hands for at least 20 seconds with soap and warm water. Don't touch your face. Cover your cough and sneezes and practice good social distancing. Your friends here at Q107.5 care about you and the safety of your family.
Let's be honest. These last few weeks were super tough, but sunnier days are here. So why not let us make your day a shade brighter by helping you craft your perfect tan? Palm Beach Tan is now open, and we've been hard at work preparing to better serve you with new safety and social distancing standards. So drop by PBT, and we'll welcome you with a free gift card for up to $55 with Premier Rewards. We can't wait to see your face. Visit PalmBeachTan.com to learn more. Palm Beach Tan, a better shade of you.
Turn up the radio.
Yeah, yeah.
The number one hit music station.
Turn the hits up.
From the Chuckles Comedy House, Q107.5 Studio.
Beck Q.
She learned from her dad. I don't be tripping on this shawty. I let her do whatever she please. I don't be kissing on this shawty. She don't be kissing on me either. She came with you and left with me. I went up a point. Let's call it even. Don't like the car. She ain't gonna end up buying her new Beamer. That girl know what she wants. She make me take it off if she see me. She say I make her wet whenever my face pop up on TV. I had to say no disrespect. Gotta do it safe or you can keep it. Pop star. I'm fresh about the trap and I'm going Bieber. She know I'm gonna call away. She can drop a pin and I come meet her. Stand next to me. You gon' end up catching a fever. I'm hot.
The number one hit music station, Q107.5, Laddie Lucky and Hope in the Morning.
It's one of those beautiful mornings that you might see in a fairy tale book. It's a phenomenal morning. It's 70, mostly sunny, getting up to 82. It's 9:23.
Coming up in just a few minutes, it is the Netflix check. We want to know what you're watching, because we've all been quarantined and social distancing. So we want to know what else you got going on out there.
Maybe it's a fairy tale.
Yeah, I need a new show.
Hope, did you actually watch the end of Vanderpump Rules?
I haven't.
I'm disappointed.
I'm just a busy girl, okay? Cool. I'll watch it tonight and let you know tomorrow.
You better do a report on it.
It's very sad.
Speaking of reports, we want to know at 375-1075, what piece of technology could you get rid of?
Maybe it's the report. Maybe you're tired of it.
TPS report? What does that mean?
Get rid of those things. You know, actually, you could definitely make the argument for the giant oversized printer. You know, that doesn't work, that you got to constantly pull paper out of. It's not doing its job. All right, you got to pull paper out of that thing every single day. And there are different compartments that the paper's in. It's becoming a real problem. Can we get rid of that? Can we get rid of the printer, please?
Yes.
What about the Apple Watch, y'all? I feel like this is just like, you already have your phone, you know?
Oh, you mean the one that's on my wrist right now?
Yeah, why? You already have a phone. You already, like, are checking your phone constantly. Why not just a regular watch? I just don't get it.
Hope, you're hating on technology.
I am.
She wants to get rid of
Apple
Alexa. She doesn't want the Apple Watch.
Right. Well, I'm glad we have a Molexic on the way for you. But let me tell you something. This Apple Watch is an investment. This thing is great. I can listen to Q107.5 on it from my app. I can actually answer phone calls. And it lets me know about traffic, too. This is like, it's an investment. It's not a piece of technology. It's a lifestyle.
Well, I didn't realize that you could listen to our app on it.
Probably checks your heart rate.
That's all I listen to is rap music on it, dude. I mean, come on. I grew up in the 90s gangster rap. Ain't nothing but a G thing, baby.
Does it tell you what your resting heartbeat is, too, and all that
stuff? It does. And like, you go to your gym, like all that kind of jazz. Man, that's one of the best pieces of technology.
Okay. Maybe not the Apple Watch thing. What about those dog feeders that you can like give them a treat while you're not there?
You want to get rid of that?
Yeah.
Because you want to feed the dog yourself?
Yeah.
I mean,
why you're not going to, your dog doesn't need a treat at every hour of every day, you know?
Depends on the dog.
Yeah.
You know, there's some really nice dogs out there that are just, they jump on you every time you see them, and you want to give them a treat as often as possible.
Look, you don't want to spoil them, though.
Oh, that's true.
Look, here's what they need to get rid of. Cheap flip-flops.
Oh, yeah.
Flip-flops is one of the greatest inventions of all time, okay? They're lightweight on you. It's easy to put on, put off. They're great things. But when you buy the cheap ones, I mean, granted, you get what you pay for.
Devastating when they snap, though.
And they do like 5 seconds after you wear these dang things, and you spend, and they're like $10, $15. They're not cheap, you know? So you wear them, the next, you know, 2 minutes later, you walk out to the parking lot, and well, there it goes. Have you ever worn flip-flops and one of them break? It ruins your entire day. You have to stop what you're doing, go all the way back home or go to said place, and I'm done.
You can't
not buy them.
You can't walk on them anymore at that stage.
You can't. They don't even, super glue won't even fix those things, dude.
Well, maybe buy some nicer flip-flops.
Cool. That's a lesson to be learned here.
I'm going to get rid of my Apple Watch and buy some better flip-flops.
Good idea.
Of a feather, you and me, we change the weather. Yeah, I'm feeling heat in December when you found me. I've been dancing on top of cars and stumbling out of bars. I follow you through the dark, can't get enough. You're the medicine and the pain, the tattoo inside my brain, and baby, you know it's obvious. I'm a sucker for you. Say the word and I'll go anywhere blindly. Sucker for you, yeah. Any road you take, you know that you'll find me. I'm a sucker for all the subliminal things no one knows about you,
about you,
about you,
about you.
And you're making my typical me break my typical rules. It's true, I'm a sucker for you.
Yeah.
Don't complicate it. Sucker for you. Say the word and I'll go anywhere blindly. I'm a sucker for you. Yeah. Any road you take, you know that you'll find me.
I'm a sucker for all.
Sucker for you.
Yeah.
Say the word and I'll go anywhere blindly. I'm a sucker for you. Yeah. Any road you take, you know that you'll find me.
I'm a sucker for all the subliminal things no one knows about you.
About you,
about you,
about you.
And you're
making the typical me
sucker for you. I'm a sucker for you.
Queen and make love to you endless. It's insane the way the name growing, money keep flowing, hustlers moving silent, so I'm tiptoeing, so keep blowing. I got it locked up like Lindsay Lohan. Put it on my life, baby. I'm gonna get you right, baby. Can't promise tomorrow, but I promise tonight. Die.
Excuse me, and I might drink a little more than I should tonight, and I might take you home with me if I could.
Yo, girl, what I'm involved with is deeper than the Masons, baby, and it ain't no secret. My family's from Cuba, but I'm an American. I don't get money like secrets. Put it on my life, baby. I make it feel right, baby. Can't promise tomorrow, but I promise tonight, darling.
Excuse me, and I might drink a little more than I should tonight, and I might take you home with me if I could.
The number one hit music station, Q107.5, Lottie, Lucky, and Hope in the Morning.
It's a great morning, too. Look at this right here. It's 70, getting up to 82, mostly sunny in Memphis, 934.
And we want to know, 375-1075, this is your Netflix check. What are you watching? And it doesn't have to be just Netflix. Hulu, Disney Plus, Amazon Prime, VHS, DVD, like, it doesn't matter.
Whatever.
Projector screen.
Projector screen.
Whatever you got.
I just finished Bates Motel. It has like 8 seasons.
That's good.
So good.
That's scary though, isn't it?
Not really, just suspenseful. But it's not going to make you have nightmares.
Well, that's good.
That's good, yeah. We don't want nightmares around here.
Yeah, no, we don't want nightmares. Yeah, that's never a good thing for anybody. It's about now that kid that's in Bates Motel, isn't he also the good doctor? Isn't that the same?
Yes.
The same child. The good doctor is that was a pretty good program. I don't know if they're still doing that one.
I saw a few episodes of that and it was good.
He was like, he's a genius and he's a good doctor as well.
I watched Back to the Future 1, 2, and 3 because they put all three of them up.
That's Lucky's movie.
That's like my favorite one. I love the second one. You watched them all in a row?
Yeah. I get like that. I just let them go. And they're such good movies. You can kind of just put them on whenever, and it's always good. You can just kind of rewatch wherever part of the movie it's at. It's easy to watch.
You know, we have some background ambiance here in the Q107.5 studio. You can see it on the stream. We have a beach scene. But you can make the argument for just having Back to the Future looping in the background. Just create some good ambiance.
We could. As long as it don't take us back to 1955, I'm happy.
No thanks.
Hope, what else are you watching out there?
Grace and Frankie's a good one.
That's funny.
Who do you like better, Grace or Frankie?
I'm going to have to go with Frankie.
Why, though?
She's just funny. I feel like Grace is a little uptight sometimes, and Frankie's just carefree, you know, lets her hair down every now and then.
Don't they kind of even each other out, though?
They do. They're a good pair.
Aw. You know what I watched the other day, too? It's a show called Grind. It's actually a movie.
It's not a dance movie?
No. right. No, that's just how we dance. But it's about like these skateboarders. It's an older movie, but it's really, really cool. And you know who's in it, Hope?
Who?
Adam Brody.
I love him.
Yeah, he plays. Yeah, he was the dude from the OC.
Mm-hmm.
Right, with the tall, black-headed dude.
Okay, yeah.
He's so cute.
He's in it, and it's basically these guys, they were trying to like get signed to a skateboarding kind of skateboarder kid, whatever. But like, yeah, it was a really good show, and I found it. I went to my mom's house, and she's got all these DVDs, and I was like, dude, I'm going to grab a couple of these, and that was one of them. And I was like, wow, it's such an older movie, but it was really good.
Let me get those. So you went through the archives, found some good ones, and you're like, Grind, that's cool.
I did. I was like, wow, I haven't seen this in forever, so, you know.
So another suspenseful show that not many people know about is What If. It's really good. You need to check that out for sure.
What's that about?
It'll keep you on your toes the whole time. I can't like tell too much, but
what if you told us?
it's a good title.
We'd be here all day.
What if you didn't tell us?
What if? 375-1075. It's the Netflix check. What are you watching?
Don't need no mentions. Yeah, these are my only intentions.
attention, we need commitment. We gotta both admit it. It's funny we both listen. It's a blessing, cause we both get it. You the best thing, and I don't need a witness. I'ma find me a ring and pray it's perfect fitted. Perfect.
Picture perfect, you don't need no filter. Filter. Just make them drop dead, you a killer. Shower you with all my attention.
I will.
Yeah, these are my only intentions.
Yeah.
Stay in the kitchen cooking up, catch your own bread.
The number one hit music station, Q1075, Laddie, Lucky, and Hope in the Morning.
Good morning, Laddie. 70 in Memphis. Mostly sunny, getting up to 82. It's 940.
All this weekend, we're basically throwing it back for you for Memorial Day, and we're getting your summer started right. Doesn't matter what you want to hear, a little Notorious B.I.G. action. Dude, we can do that for you.
Some Old NSYNC, whatever you want.
Yeah.
Doesn't really matter what it is. Doesn't matter what you're watching either, though.
Not at all. This is your Netflix check at 375-1075. I'm getting tired of watching the same stuff over and over and over again. We need some new things.
It'd be very frustrating.
So one of my favorite documentaries just came back on Netflix.
What's that?
Blackfish.
Yes.
Such a good one. I could probably watch this over and over and over and not get tired of it.
That's the whale story, right? It deals with how the whales.
Yeah, the orcas at SeaWorld.
Are they sharks? They're sharks, not whales, right? The sharks are being mistreated at SeaWorld.
No, it's the orcas.
Orca whales.
The orca whales, yeah, they're getting mistreated at SeaWorld.
Yeah.
Just bad living conditions or not getting fed the right nutrients and stuff like that, or what?
And then, like, that causes them to act out and hurt people, and it's just a long, like, interesting documentary.
We're treating them good now, though, right? Like, we're giving them the perks they need, their own trailer and stuff like
that.
Yeah, yeah. Their own trailer, their own makeup artist. Like, everything's fine now. We're good. We're back to normal.
We don't want them to get upset, for sure. We got a text coming through on the text line. Frasier is suggesting not to watch Frasier, but to watch Monk. You ever watched?
I loved that show growing up.
Yeah, Monk. That was an interesting show. He's like a really smart detective. Could always figure it out. I remember Monk.
And he was a germ freak, so I bet he didn't get coronavirus.
I promise you, yeah, he would wash his hands all the time.
He's probably going to figure out how to beat the coronavirus. We also got a tweet from Shelly17, and she just said that Back to the Future is awesome, but what her and her husband have been doing is rewatching all the Rocky movies.
Oh, yes.
Wow. There's like, what, 6 or 7 of them now? It's like, wow.
Well, can I be honest with you guys? I've never seen those. Not one.
Wait, say that again?
I've never seen them.
Well, hope's fired. Hey, if you want to come work for Q1075, give us a
call. Hey, you got something to look forward to now. It's nice to have not watched some of these classics, because now you get to watch them.
Yeah.
You've never seen Rocky.
Mm-mm. Nope.
I want to take a minute to talk to the Carols for a second. Dear Mama and Papa Carol, your daughter is very knows what's going on in this world. How does she not know what Rocky is? We need to let her know about Rocky. I mean, Mr. T's in it. To one
yeah,
of
Mr.
them.
D's in it.
Hulk Hogan's in one of them.
Oh, no way.
Absolutely. The tall Russians in there.
The tall Russians in there.
Really,
come on. Remember?
Really good one.
Adrian! Adrian!
You've heard that. You remember that, right?
Maybe I'll watch it this weekend, but I'm stuck on The Sinner right now.
No. Look, hold on. Let's go back for a second. You have a boyfriend who has a beard, okay?
Whoa,
so, you're dating a guy who has a beard. He's watched Rocky, I guarantee it.
I'm sure. I feel like every guy's watched Rocky.
Yeah, you guys should watch that together. Be a great bonding experience.
I just feel like it's not really a girl's show.
No, Adrian's in it.
Adrian! It's like a love story. It's a love story, and then boxing is just a little bit of it.
That's a sidebar. It's a sidebar.
Hey, what else are you watching, you said? Sinner?
The Sinner, yes. That's another good one. Jessica Biel was in the first season of it, and it's like each season kind of changes. It's a different, the same, not detective. Yeah, maybe he is a detective. Same detective guy's in it, but it's based on different people he's kind of like shadowing and like seeing what's wrong with them because they have like certain, I don't know, it's really good.
You gotta watch it.
You know,
just gotta watch it.
Look, I need some help finding a show. There was a show on HBO and it was called Vinyl. Do y'all remember this?
No.
I remember Vinyl.
It was awesome. And it's about basically a guy working in a record industry for a record label. And he's trying to find bands and stuff, whatever. Anyways, like the first three episodes of this show are fantastic. And it's really cool because it's basically made in like the early 70s, or that's when it's supposed to be taking place. And it just shows how the record business is, how it is finding all these different artists. Man, it's really, really cool.
That sounds interesting.
Yeah, but I Googled it and I was like, I can't find it anywhere.
It's
the worst. It's going to make me download it somewhere.
Please send Laddie a bootlegged link of that, please.
I mean, you know, even if it's called vinyl, I will still watch it.
Or let us know what you're watching so we can have something to do this weekend.
375-1075. It's the Netflix check.
Q1075, the number one hit music station.
I've always been the one to say the first goodbye. Had to love and lose 100 million times. Had to get it wrong to know just what I like. Now I'm falling. You say my name like I have never heard before. I'm indecisive, but this time I know for sure. I hope I'm not the only one that feels it all.
What have you done in the name of fashion? My friend Steven FaceTimed me the other day and said, look what I did. He shaved a sliver of his eyebrow off.
Ah, Charlie Puth wannabe.
Anyone else do anything in the name of fashion? Dan, you never did anything that you thought was cool?
But it was nice to straighten my hair because I wanted to be like Brendan Urie, but I still think that's pretty cool.
See you tonight. Zach Sang Show.
Hey, it's Laddie from the Q Morning Show on Q107.5. And I got to talk about my brand new apartment at Centennial Gardens. It's conveniently located at Hacks Cross in Winchester, right next to the interstate. So if you're going to be out in East Memphis, Midtown, or even downtown, they've got you covered and you're right off the interstate. Plus, they have three pools, so you can go ahead and get that tan during the summer whenever you'd like. They also have dog parks, one bedroom, two bedroom, even three bedrooms. So if you got a big family or if it's just you, they have you covered. Very spacious and high ceilings. So no matter what's going on in your life and going on, they have definitely have you covered. And it's right by Germantown Elementary School, Middle School, and High School. So you're going to get a great education. And it's conveniently right there located around shopping and eateries. The only place you need to be is Centennial Gardens. You can reach them now at 758-8855 or go online. Centennial Gardens, APTS.com. And it's a specialty management group.
Welcome to Triumph Auto Sales, where you'll have a great car buying experience. Triumph Auto Sales is your number one source of quality pre-owned vehicles ranging from lease returns to new car trades, all at huge savings. Plus, Triumph has a full array of financing options to meet your needs. Find your next car online at TriumphAutoSales.com or stop in today at 4875 Elmore Road. Triumph Auto Sales will help you get the vehicle you want at the price you need and the service you deserve. For a great car and a great experience from a local and family-owned business, visit Triumph Auto Sales.
I've always wanted to learn another language, so I decided to give Babbel a try, and I really like the teaching method of the app. I started with the beginner lesson on Babbel, and soon you're putting words into a conversation. Each lesson takes about 10 to 15 minutes, and they're all really different, which keeps things interesting. I can't wait to use my Spanish skills in real life. Dos cervezas, por favor.
Now try Babbel free. Just go to Babbel.com or download the Babbel app. That's Babbel.com.
Back to the hits from the Chuckles Comedy House. Chuckles Comedy House. Chuckles Comedy House. Q107.5 Studio.
Q107.5.
Cause I want you, bad. Yeah, I want you, baby. I've been thinking about it all day, and I hope you feel the same way. Cause I want you, bad. Yeah, I want you, baby. Slow, slow hands, like sweat dripping down my dead laundry. No, no chance that I'm leaving. Yeah, I want you, baby, slow, slow hands, like a sweat dripping down my dirty laundry. No, no chance that I'm leaving you without you on me. I know, yeah, I already know that there ain't no stopping your plans in those slow hands. Fingertips putting on a show, got me now and against the no. Wanna be with you
Q107.5 Artist Discovery, brought to you by Columbia Records. It's Diplo, featuring Morgan Wallen and Julia Michaels, Heartless.
Say you're going out late, I count down till you call me. It's just one of those things that you do when you're lonely. And you're all about the chase, but you won't ever let me catch you. And I wish it was the same, but I know I'm gonna let you in again. And when I do, it's gonna hurt like hell. And you don't mean to, it's what I tell myself. But why you gotta be so heartless? I know you think it's harmless. You're tearing me apart, and girl, the hardest part is you're so out of attention, taking my surroundings. Leave me in the darkness, never finish what we started. Why you gotta be so heartless?
Another fight. Wednesday, I thought everything would change. Thursday came and it was still the same. Friday night, we went out on the town. Saturday, we should've burned it down. Sunday morning came and now you're gone. I should probably know by now. Oh, I should probably know by now.
Brought to you by Columbia Records and Q107.5.
Q107.5.
Hey, it's Dua Lipa.
Hey, it's Lil Nas X.
Hey, guys, it's Selena Gomez on Q107.5.
Duh.